Hi, this is a quick video on Simulink and MATLAB. So think about a situation. This is for the simplicity, I've just considered a simple example. So this is a simple example generating a sine wave, and it has a gain so that I can see the output in oscilloscope after the gain, right? So think about this situation. So just let me run the simulation first. Okay, simulation is running, right? Okay, so think about that. So that means the sine wave is multiplication by this gain, right? But if I change the gain, let me show you, the gain is 50. So now my sine wave output is changing, you see? So now sine wave peak output is more than 40. If I change this gain to 20, again, that means my output is changing, right? But when I'm automating a things for any experiment, I need to change this programmatically so that I can sweep the value from 0 to 50 or 0 to 100 or 200. So it is very tedious to do such type of things just pressing the GUI, right? So we need something for automation. So now in this video, I'll show you how you can automate this process. So the video is mainly on how you can change Simulink model parameter from MATLAB command line or MATLAB script. So this is the main goal of this video, right? So I hope you got the main idea of this video. So let me show you how you can do this one. Okay, so for doing this, first you need the MATLAB file name, that is the sim model, right? So first let me close this model. Okay, and next thing you need to know the name of the block which you want to change, that is gain one, right? So what you have to do, so just you have to write a function set param, right? And after that you will provide a string. The value of this string should be the simulation name, sim model, and after that there would be a slash, and after slash, so the after slash the block would be the block, then after slash the block name which you want to change, right? And that is the gain one. And after that you will so in a gain one, in any block there might be a multiple parameter to update, right? So in this case that is the gain I want to change, so this should be the parameter name, right? So I have to put that name gain, right? And after that I will put the value of the gain. The value should be in string format, so now I'll put 30, such an example, right? So let me see whether this work or not. Okay, that means this value should be 30. You see, so now the value changed from 20 to 30. So in this way I can change any value from any parameters from the MATLAB, right? So this is very helpful when you want to automate any simulation while you, on the runtime. So let me show you the example in runtime. So let me just start the simulation first so that I can show you how I can do this in runtime. So the simulation is running and I want to change the value in runtime from 30 to 10. See, now I can change my value in runtime so that I can automate whole process, and when I need to change any variable or any parameters inside, or electrical parameters, or the parameter might be constant, so I can do this using this easy step. So in this way I can automate my process. Let me show you the end script I have developed so that I can show you. I have changed my value from, this is a simple script. Thus in the simple script I'm just changing the value from 0 to 50, right? So that I can see the effect in the graph. Okay, so I will run this script now. The script is doing the same thing, set the parameter sim model slash gain one, this is the name of the block, and after that the gain is the properties of the gain one block. Okay, now I will run this script, see what happens next. See, the gain value is first 0, after 2 seconds, 1, 2. So that means gain value is just increasing gradually, and I'm seeing the effect on the simulation. So this is a nice way when you want to automate a big simulation, and so you don't have to do, or you don't have to change the parameter every time you are changing. So in this way you can automate your simulation, you can change any parameter of the simulation. But the question is how you can change any specific electrical or any specific parameters. So in the MATLAB file or in the MATLAB help directory, you will find which property you can change. So this is the my GitHub repository where you will find all those files related to today's experiment. And if you go to this link, you will see the list. So this is the whole list in where you can find out how to change the parameter and which parameter you can change. So I hope this will be helpful. So another thing I can show you, so let me show you this thing. So this is the MDL file, right? If you open this MDL file using a text editor, this is a simple text editor. Let me show you open this MDL file. So you can open this MDL or model file using a text editor, see? And if I just find gain one, so this is the gain one, right? So you can see in the gain one, and this is the name of the, this is the value of the gain one property. You can see all those property here in the particular block. So you can see which property you can change, which property you cannot change. The this another you can view which property to change, right? So I think all those tips will be helpful for you. And if you like my video, please subscribe to my channel. And if you have any question or any suggestion, please put your comment here. Thank you.